From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of cultures, traditions, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, to date the country is taking huge strides on the path of development. Namaskar viewers, welcome back to another episode of My India. I'm your host Prateeksha Mishra, and in today's episode, we're going to offer you a glimpse into India's cultures, diversity, along with the developments happening in and around the world. India, an abode to ancient wonders and intermingling cultures, once again embarks upon its year-long festive journey of joy and pleasure with the chants of Jai Mata Di celebrating the Chaitra Navratri, a 9-day-long Hindu festival, and Ram Navami, the birth of Lord Ram. The vibrant celebration reflected India's rich cultural tapestry while also symbolized the triumph of good over evil. Take a look.
Known for its cultural richness and diverse ethnicity, India, a land of fairs and festivals, is once again treading on its year-long cultural and religious journey. With that, the slogans of Jai Mata Di echoed in the ears across the country as devotees flocked religious destinations to celebrate Chait Navratri, a Hindu festival dedicated to Goddess Durga. Chaitra Navratri, also known as Vasant Navratri, is a 9-day Hindu festival that celebrates the 9 forms of Goddess Durga: Shailaputri, Brahmacharini, Chandraghanta, Kushmanda, Skandamata, Katyayini, Kalratri, Mahagauri, and Siddhidatri. For the 9 days, these 9 manifestations of Hindu Goddess Durga are worshipped, marking the victory of good over evil. Chaitra Navratri generally falls in the Hindu calendar month of Chaitra between March and April and is celebrated with gaiety and fervour by devotees all across the world.
Vasantik Navratra ka dutiya divas hai aur dutiya divas Ma Brahmacharini ke swaroop ke naam se jana jata hai. Brahmacharini arthat tapascharini, inhe tapasya ki devi kaha gaya hai. ब्रह्मचारिणी कठोर, ब्रह्मचारिणी का एक नाम है कठोर तप. इन्होंने ये राजा हिमालय के घर में पुत्री रूप में इन्होंने जन्म लिया और नारद जी की सलाह से इन्होंने भगवान शंकर को पति रूप में पाने के लिए कठोर तपस्या करी.
Coinciding with the arrival of spring, Chaitra Navratri marks a fresh start. The festival also signifies the Hindu New Year according to the Vikram Samvat calendar. During the 9-day-long festival, devotees observe fast, abstain from certain kinds of foods, and meditate to rejuvenate inflow of new energy within them. As part of tradition, devotees also chant mantras, prayers, and sing devotional songs in the morning and evenings, filling the atmosphere with positive energy throughout the festival.
यहाँ पे हम लोग एक तो माता जी के दर्शन करना था पहला लक्ष्य, और अपना परिवार के लिए, देश के सुख शांति के लिए, गांव का हमारे शांति के लिए हम लोग आए हैं. थोड़ा इसके लिए नवरात्र का पहला दिन चूज किया. मैं पिछले महीने में राम मंदिर भी गया था, वहाँ पर भी देखा, लेकिन यहाँ का जो सजावट है वहाँ से बेहतर है. इस बार बहुत सुंदर है, मतलब ऐसा मैंने सजावट कभी देखा नहीं था.
Over the 9 days, devotees focus on specific form, offering prayers and performing rituals to invoke divine blessings. Furthermore, the 9th and the final day of the festival culminates in Ram Navami, commemorating the birth of Lord Ram. In an instance, on the occasion of Ram Navami, the country also witnessed the Shri Ramcharitmanas, one of the greatest Hindu epic in Hindu literature, penned by Indian poet and writer Tulsidas, being immortalized as a Chennai-based jeweler crafted the timeless saga of Lord Ram on 522 gold-plated pages, marking it a testament of devotion.
So it's a very prestigious and a very honorable thing for us to do it. For the main fact, It's going to be placed inside the Sanctum Sanctorum, and very few things are actually placed inside. And this is one or another opportunity after the Sengol, what my grandfather had got. This is another opportunity for Vumadi to have done this. And we are so happy and thankful to the temple authority.
People during the event wear new clothes, prepare delicacies, and also exchange gifts to foster a strong bond among family and friends. Meanwhile, the festival is a time for inner reflection, a celebration of the divine feminine, and a joyous welcome to the vibrant season of spring.
Moving on, India recently celebrated Eid ul-Fitr, a festival of unity and brotherhood, forgiving and embracing each other, transcending religious divides. People from various Indian states gathered at religious sites to offer namaz and partake in celebratory feast, while also exchanged well wishes of Eid Mubarak amongst all. Take a look.
The culture of India is a unique blend of age-old civilization, traditions, and diversity, the spirit of which is often commemorated with festivals and carnivals organized time and again to cherish the cultural diversity of the country. Festivals in India are not just a moment to strengthen healthy relationships within a family, they also bring communities and society as a whole together to rejoice in the spirit of harmony and brotherhood. Observing the essence of a nation's unity, recently India celebrated Eid al-Fitr, also called Eid, a Muslim festival, marking the end of the month-long dawn to sunset fasting of Ramadan. Ramadan is a month that not only commemorates the 30-day long fast, iftar, taraweeh, acts of charity and the festive atmosphere, but also involves gathering with family and friends for a celebratory meal. Furthermore, the holy month comes to an end with the sighting of the new moon celebrating Eid al-Fitr.
तो सबसे पहले हम आज जब पूरे चाहे वो कोई भी मजहब सिख मुसलमान हिंदू क्रिश्चियन सब ये त्यौहार सबके लिए होता है सबको ईद मुबारक दे देते हैं और ये रमज़ान का महीना जिस महीने में हमने इबादत की ये हमने खुद के लिए नहीं की बल्कि पूरे आलम के लिए की खुसूसन हमारे हिंदुस्तान के लिए हिंदुस्तान के भाइयों के लिए चाहे हिंदू हो मुसलमान हो उनके लिए इबादत की हम चाहते हैं कि अल्लाह उन सबको जो है खुशियाँ नसीब करे और हम चाहते हैं कि इस इंडिया में पूरे मुल्क में जो है अमन अमान हो मुसलमान मुसलमान हिंदू सिख क्रिश्चियन भाईचारे से रहे।
ईद अल फितर इज सेलिब्रेटेड ऑन द फर्स्ट डे ऑफ शवल द 10th मंथ ऑफ द इस्लामिक लूनर कैलेंडर ड्यूरिंग द ओकेजन डेविटीज अक्रॉस द कंट्री ऑफर प्रेयर्स साइटिंग द मून एट द ईद का एंड डॉनिंग न्यू अटायर marking the conclusion of the sacred month of Ramadan. Muslims express their gratitude to God for the strength and blessings received during Ramadan. Moreover, the occasion also encourages followers to focus more on charitable works, meditation and self-reflection. As the day comes after a month of fasting, devotees decorate their houses, prepare delicious cuisine and encourage to forgive each other.
आज ईद है यहाँ पे आज हमने जामा मस्जिद पे ईद मनाई और बहुत सारे लोगों के साथ बहुत सुंदर सेलिब्रेशन थी सब साथ में आके सबने साथ में सेलिब्रेट किया
ड्यूरिंग द ओकेजन मार्केट्स अक्रॉस द कंट्री वर आल्सो सीन बसलिंग विद फेस्टिव लाइट एंड फर्वर एज मुस्लिम्स टुक टू द स्ट्रीट्स टू बाय फेस्टिव डेकोरेशंस स्वीट्स क्लोथ्स एंड गिफ्ट्स From traditional outfits to modern trends, the markets were adorned with a wide range of items. Shopkeepers were displaying the best merchandise, while customers were browsing the best Eid fit for themselves. Moreover, the festival also witnessed workers from different communities collaborating to fulfill the demands of the religious group, such as supplying vermicelli and soot feni, used as part of the worship rituals.
ईद में हमारे रसगुल्ले, अब लास्ट डे के तो रसगुल्ले मिठाइयाँ निकलेंगे, अभी तक तो नमकीन वगैरह निकल रहे हैं सारे, तो अब थोड़ा सा कतला महफिल ही निकल रहा है, तो अब आखिरी में हमारा आज जो लास्ट एक दो दिन रहते हैं उसमें रसगुल्ले और गुलाब जामुन वगैरह निकलेंगे, तो उसकी तैयारियाँ चल रही हैं पूरी।
ईद अल फितर ब्रिंग्स अ वाइब्रेंट एंड जॉयस एटमॉस्फेयर टू मुस्लिम कम्युनिटीज वर्ल्ड वाइड। इट्स अ सेलिब्रेशन ऑफ फेथ, फैमिली एंड टुगेदरनेस। मोरओवर, festivals like these also provide opportunities for the local vendors to bring happiness to their families in the form of income.
And now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
English translation of Jayant Patil's Magahi novel Phool Bahadur was launched in New Delhi. The novel, translated by renowned poet and diplomat Abhay Kumar, emphasizes on celebration of rich cultural heritage of Bihari literature and its global significance. The event was held under presence of renowned filmmakers and acclaimed writers. Renowned poet Abhay Kumar, the translator of the book, hoped that his translation would open doors for more translations of regional languages of Bihar. Hundreds of Hindu devotees thronged India's temple city Prayagraj to take a dip in the holy river of Ganga on the auspicious occasion of Somvati Amavasya, or a No Moon Monday.
और ये सब लोग सोमवती अमावस्या का जो पर्व है, स्नान करने मात्र से ही हमारे पितर हमारी ध्यान करते, उनका मुक्त हो जाता है और हमारी जो आने वाली पीढ़ी है उनका भी कल्याण होता है।
रिवर गंगा बैंक्स टीम्ड विद डिवोटीज हु ऑफर्ड प्रेयर्स एंड वेटेड टू टेक अ डिप। इट इज बिलीव्ड दैट टेकिंग अ डिप इन होली वाटर्स ऑफ गंगा वॉश अवे लाइफ टाइम्स ऑफ सिंस। Married women take a dip for a happy married life and for a long life of their husbands. They also worship the peepal tree on the day while performing different rituals and undertaking Somvati Amavasya Vrat. According to the Hindu epic Mahabharat, Bhishma, son of River Ganga, narrated the significance of Somvati Amavasya to Yudhishthir, the eldest of the five Pandav brothers. Bhishma said that whoever takes a bath in the sacred river on this day would be prosperous, disease-free and free from grief and sorrow. Weeks before India heads into a two-month-long election with nearly 1 billion voters, political party merchandise and flag makers are expanding operations and working overtime to meet a surge in demand.
अब जैसे जैसे इलेक्शन नजदीक आता जा रहा है, उस दौरान अब जो चुनाव प्रचार सामग्री जो बिकने का सेल रहता है, इसकी अभी सरगर्मी बहुत ज़्यादा तेज होती चली जा रही है। अभी क्या है कि जैसे जैसे जौन से स्टेट में जौन से चरण का इलेक्शन नजदीक आता जाएगा, उस जगह पर जो है सरगर्मी और ज़्यादा तेज होती चली जाएगी।
With the first voting day of the 7-phase election nearing, garment makers are temporarily converting factories where they usually make saris into production hubs for election flags and banners. Election merchandise is a low-margin, high-volume business where the price of a party badge can start from 1 rupee. During an election, India is plastered with posters from hundreds of political parties and thousands of candidates. Elections give the economy a boost as political parties spend on goods and services as varied as small merchandise and helicopter rental. Gulshan Khurana, General Secretary of a Traders Association in Delhi's Sadar Bazaar Market, said political parties spend 30 billion to 50 billion rupees on election merchandise, creating as many as 10 million jobs.
Moving on, India's fashion industry is carving a unique niche on the global stage. It seamlessly blends modern aesthetics with the country's rich cultural heritage. Traditional garments like saris, suits, सलवार कमीज एंड लहंगाज आर रीइंटरप्रेटेड बाय इंडियन डिजाइनर्स resulting in a fresh and distinctive look that's gaining international recognition. Adding to that, the frequent hosting of major fashion shows across Indian states is further strengthening the India's position on global platforms. Take a look.
From styling and carrying dresses with matching accessories like ornaments, hats, footwear and handbags, to living up to the latest trend while expressing oneself in their truest form, fashion has evolved with time. While India is known for its rich culture and culturally influenced design of fabrics, the Indian fashion industry is emerging to lead the world with its rich array of traditional and Indo-Western designer pieces. In fact, the Indian fashion scenarios were never as colorless as it seems. As in the 1950s, 60s and 70s, they were way more exciting, chic and elegant. Back then, there were no designers, models or fashion labels that the country could show off. Moreover, the value of a garment was judged by its style and fabric and not by who made it. Today, the industry is known worldwide for its fusion patterns and cross-cultural textile designs. With that, Indian designers are breathing new life into traditional attire with their exquisite craftsmanship and trend-setting expressions. This approach also ensures Indian fashion stays relevant in the modern world and aligns with international trends. Consequently, the Indian fashion designers have formed a special identity for themselves while their designs are gaining special attention at fashion platforms like fashion shows organized in and around the globe.
This cosmos is not just a collection. It's an idea of inclusivity. Idea that does not showcase my excellence. The idea which showcase a group's excellence. The idea which showcase this best of craftsmanship, which in a most simple form can happen from different villages. So today we engage and work with at least 800 to 900 villagers on regular level.
From donning oneself in feathery and shimmering dresses with long strings of pearls and headbands to Indo-Western and culturally influenced attires, India has come a long way. Today, the fashion shows organized in the country are not just providing platforms for fashion designers to present their creative designs, but also bringing many opportunities for future endeavors. Recently, Mumbai hosted a similar fashion week, which was joined by many renowned Bollywood actresses participating and walking to the ramp, donning captivating attire made by Indian designers.
I think my biggest fashion tip would be ki be comfortable in your own skin. Jo aapko acha lag raha hai, wo definitely aapke acha lag raha hai. Jab aap sheeshe mein khud ko dekhte ho aur aapko muskurane ka man kare, you know you're perfect. That's all.
A special thing about the Indian fashion industry is sustainability. With the changing times, the trend towards eco-friendly fashion and organic fabrics is increasing, owing to which designers are now slowly shifting and emphasizing more towards making dresses environmentally friendly. Furthermore, natural fibers like khadi and jute are rapidly being used in the manufacturing of new dresses, which not only benefits the environment but are also setting a new trend in the fashion world.
India has naturally been sustainable in its history. You know how khadi is made, or how a lot of textiles in India are made and hand woven. And it's not just sustainable ecologically, but environmentally, but it's also sustainable in a sociological atmosphere where employment is fair and it's given, and there's a whole system to
A report also suggests that the export of ready-made garments from India will exceed $30 billion by 2027, which is considered a good sign for the fashion industry. This surge is also fueled by increasing digitalization and online marketing. Meanwhile, making Indian fashion accessible globally is creating new opportunities for designers.
And now, we bring you some of the stories from the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section of World in Focus.
Named after the oil painting of Spanish painter Pablo Picasso, a cafe in the southern Iraqi city of Basra aims to bring together different points of views by opening a space for artists and others.
بذره الفكره هي كانت عباره عن انه انت توفر مجرد انه توفر ادوات رسم للرسامين وبعدها بلشت الفكره تتطور شوي شوي الى ان صارت الحاجه بانه انت تبادر وتنطي هذا المشروع اللي هو يوفر لك مكان ترسم به بالاضافه انه يوفر لك المشروبات الحاره او البارده والمأكولات وغيرها فالحاجه هي سبب انه انت تنشئ هذا المشروع وتسميه باسم غارنيكا.
Some customers painted, others sketched, and some were there just to hang out. Al-Basri said the cafe, which opened 2 months ago, started as an idea to connect painters with drawing tools. He said a new idea for the cafe would be a menu of drawing tools rather than food. Ten-year-old Brazilian painter Sofia Helena is getting ready for what she describes as the most surreal experience of her life to expose her works in Paris.
E assim com meus 9 anos eu já comecei a pintar profissionalmente, né? Em tela, aí eu comecei a fazer meu curso, comecei a fazer minha primeira tela. E aí minha mãe ela me inscreveu, né, para concorrer para expor minhas obras no Carrossel do Louvre. E hoje eu estou pintando para eu poder expor minhas obras lá.
Sofia's talent was first discovered when she was 6 years old by an art teacher. Since then, with the help of her family and art classes, Sofia has further developed her talent. One of her inspirations is Vincent van Gogh, who Sofia says she feels connected to because of how he would transmit his feelings to the canvas. After winning a contest, Sofia will showcase her work in October in the private gallery located at the Carrousel du Louvre near the famous museum. Julian's Auctions is hosting a 2-day sale titled Tony Bennett, A Life Well Lived, to celebrate the life and career of the jazz vocalist in New York.
We have over 700 lots that are going to the auction block, a lot of mementos that really shaped, framed Tony as a person, as an artist, and as a musician.
The auction will feature items from Bennett's 8-decade career, including personal belongings, original artwork, and memorabilia. Bennett was well known for his performances of popular classics from the Great American Songbook. His masterful recordings, including his signature 1962 hit, I Left My Heart in San Francisco, have become cultural touchstones. Beyond his musical legacy, Bennett was also a respected painter and sketch artist, with many of his works being included in the auction. Award-winning set designer David Corins is the creative director of the exhibition. Among the highlights of the auction are a David Hockney portrait of Bennett and Ian Wright's framed portrait from Bennett's 2006 album Duets, Bennett's original watercolor works, and a large leather birthday scrapbook filled with messages from prominent figures. The auction will also feature stage and studio equipment used by Bennett, including one of his primary performance microphones and a Hofner harmonica played by Stevie Wonder.
And lastly, the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir in India is once again in the spotlight. This time, its Tulip Garden, which is considered Asia's largest flower garden, is garnering so much attention as recently over lakhs of tourists from India and across the world gathered to witness the annual flower show. Take a look. India's Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir, often known for its serene atmosphere and alluring landscape, boasts a unique cultural identity shaped and influenced by history and geography. The region beyond this also maintains a harmonious blend among the diverse communities, Hindus, Muslims, Sikhs and Christians, through its age-old music, literature, art and crafts. For all that, Kashmiris are known for their warm hospitality, offering visitors a glimpse into their tradition and way of life. Keeping with the spirit, the valley welcomed over 2 lakh tourists and locals from around the world within the span of just 2 weeks to the largest tulip garden in India's northern Kashmir to witness the freshly blossomed flowers. The world-famous flower garden, which is considered as Asia's largest tulip garden, has been opened for the tourists from 23rd of March.
It's like spring in Switzerland. It's the same. A lot of trees with green trees and blossoms. I don't see a big difference between Switzerland and Kashmir here right now, yeah.
Siraj Bagh, also known as Gulle Lala in the local language, is a popular tulip garden situated in the foothills of the Zabruwan Mountains. With its extraordinarily beautiful ambience, the garden offers a truly enchanting experience that exceeds the expectations of tourists. During the flower show, people were also seen taking photographs and videos to capture the picturesque scenery as hundreds of varieties of tulips bloomed in full glory.
सच्ची में स्वर्ग है. हमने बस YouTube में वीडियोस में देखा था, लेकिन मुझे लगता है यहाँ आके जब आप खुद एक्सपीरियंस करेंगे तो आपको लगेगा कि ये सच्ची में जन्नत है. और मैं तो इस जगह का नाम कश्मीर से जन्नत कर देना चाहिए. बहुत सुंदर ट्यूलिप गार्डन है, बहुत अच्छा लगा.
लास्ट ईयर द टोटल फुटफॉल ऑफ टूरिस्ट वॉज रिकॉर्डेड टू बी 372,000. Though this year suggests a surge in tourist influx, while the figure may surpass the previous year's record. The iconic destination is often crowded by tourists and locals alike in the spring season from mid of March to the end of April.
पहले तो मैं शुक्रगुजार हूँ पूरी मीडिया फ्रेटर्निटी का, बहुत इलेक्ट्रॉनिक हो, प्रिंट मीडिया हो, एंड दोज जो सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म से भी ऑपरेट करते हैं, फॉर गिविंग सच अ वंडरफुल पब्लिसिटी टू दिस एपिटमी ऑफ ब्यूटी. और जिसकी वजह से पूरी दुनिया को आज रिकॉग्निशन है इस टुलिप गार्डन की, क्योंकि एशिया का सबसे बड़ा लार्जेस्ट टुलिप गार्डन है. तो हर साल ये टूरिस्ट्स को अपनी तरफ अट्रैक्ट करता है. जैसे कि पिछले साल का जैसे हमारा काउंट है वो ऑलमोस्ट 4.5 लाख था, 3.75 के आसपास. तो इस बार वी आर होपफुल कि जो ये वाला साल है 2024 का शो जो होगा ये एक रिकॉर्ड ब्रेकिंग शो होगा इन टर्म्स ऑफ टूरिस्ट अटेंडेंस.
द फेमस गार्डन हैज बीन फेलिसिटेटेड बाय द वर्ल्ड्स बुक ऑफ रिकॉर्ड्स लंदन फॉर बीइंग द फर्स्ट सच गार्डन इन एशिया. Such events not only promote region's culture but also provides opportunities to the locals to earn a fair income. And that's all we have for you this week. I'm your host Pratiksha Mishra, and it's a goodbye from the entire production team.